Jessie V, and in today's video, we're going to be talking about the very dark origins of Cruella de Vil. I got inspired to make this video because of that new movie that is out. I haven't seen it though. Don't hate me, I haven't seen it yet. But I really wanted to talk about the OG Cruella de Vil, who she was inspired by. Is there a true story behind her? The answer is yes. It's actually so creepy, so interesting. You guys are gonna love it. Before I get started though, do you see what my shirt says? It says, "My wings are just hiding right now," because I'm a secret fairy. And guess what, guys? This is our new merch. This is the summer merch that I have come up with. I just love this quote so much. It's so cute and just so like real. But I just love the design, and even cooler is that on the back of the shirt, there's wings. Let me show you.
Guys, look! And it says Jessie V in the wings. I love it so much.
So these are limited edition just for the summer. So once they sell out, they sell out. I have linked it down below. But we have t-shirts and we have tank tops. So this t-shirt comes in this charcoal gray, and it also comes in white. And then our tank tops come in white and black. So these t-shirts are true to size, but I just want to mention that the tank tops, they fit very loosely. So if you want it to fit snug, I would actually size down. But if you're okay with it fitting kind of loose, then just stick with your normal size. But yeah, I've been wearing this everywhere. I love it so much. So if you would like it, I've linked it down below. Are your wings hiding right now? Are you a real fairy? Also, I mentioned this in my last video, but the Monster High video is up on channel memberships if you want to watch it. I've linked the member join stuff down below in the description. All right, guys, so without further ado, let's talk about Cruella de Vil. Cruella de Vil is the main antagonist of Disney's 1961 animated feature film 101 Dalmatians. She is an eccentric, fashion-obsessed woman who wishes to use the skins of 99 Dalmatian puppies to create a spotted fur coat. She's regarded as a witch and a devil woman, and her infatuation with furs drives her to murderous insanity. Now, when I was a kid, I probably saw the OG movie maybe once because she freaked me out so much. She actually really disturbed me. Like, I barely remember the movie. That's how long ago I saw it. And I did consider that maybe I should rewatch it since I'm doing a whole video on it, but I'm still scared of her, so I decided not to. I just couldn't and still can't understand why someone would want to go after like innocent puppies. It's just really sad to me. So let's talk about the book, because not a lot of people know that before this was ever a movie, it was first a novel. This was a children's novel by Dodie Smith that came out in 1956, and it actually had a lot of very dark elements. So I'm going to be telling you some things that happened in the books that Disney purposely left out because it was that creepy, that dark, that horrible. The first weird fact that they talked about in the book is that Cruella de Vil's grandfather was actually a killer. In the book, there's this huge house called Hell Hall, and this has always been the property of the de Vil family. Well, it was once owned by Cruella's grandfather, and the villagers truly believed that he was a killer. They apparently always heard screaming coming from his home at night, and they would always make sure to count their children and their grandchildren before they went to bed, because they were literally afraid that he would come and like kidnap them. The rumor is that he would take his victims and bring them back to Hell Hall. One day, the villagers decided to go and burn down his house, and when they arrived, there was this terrible thunderstorm that came out of nowhere, and it extinguished their torches. Suddenly, the front door of Hell Hall opened, and out stepped Cruella's grandfather, and apparently he had this blue lightning coming out of his body. So the villagers were terrified and never returned again. So the rumor is that there is something really evil in Cruella's family history, and that's why she is the way she is. The next weird fact in the book is that Cruella has this very creepy relationship with fire and pepper. I know how weird that sounds. Throughout the story, Cruella is wearing her absolutely simple white mink coat and is constantly cold. So she insists on stoking fires in her home around the clock and will creepily stare into the fire for hours at a time. She also puts an unreal amount of pepper on everything she eats. It's like she just wants everything to be unbearably hot. Her house, her food, just everything. That's why a lot of people think that she literally comes from down under, if you know what I mean, the hot area. The next disturbing things in the book is about her cats and her puppies. Now, before I continue, I just want to let you know one more time that everything I'm about to tell you is fictional. It didn't actually happen. It's not actually real. But if you get upset by like animals and stuff, fast forward like a minute maybe. But yeah, this is a fictional story, but it's still very disturbing, which is why Disney decided to keep this part out of the movie. movies. In the novel, Cruella has a white Persian cat that she keeps for its value, and she says that each time the cat gets pregnant, she goes and drowns the kittens one by one. And the book says that she had 44 kittens. Had. And then she eventually wants to get rid of her puppies as well. So she suggests that they should lock the puppies in a room all together, not give them any food so that they would be forced to eat each other. To eat each other. So yeah, that's probably the most disturbing part in the novel. Like I said, it's fictional, didn't actually happen, never will happen. The next interesting fact is that she has a husband in the novel. Yes, she is married and his name is Mr. DeVille because he took her last name. Apparently, he is an animal skin collector and he's basically helping Cruella build her fur empire. He speaks very little and seems to do her every will. So he's almost like her servant, essentially. All right, so now that you know all the deep dark secrets of the original novel, let's talk about the real life inspiration for Cruella. When Dodie Smith's novel, The 101 Dalmatians, hit the shelves in 1956, world famous animator and studio head Walt Disney reportedly loved the book so much that he wanted to adapt it into his next animated project. Now, a woman named Tallulah Bankhead was Disney's main inspiration for creating this animated character. She was a theater actress with expressive, unmissable facial expressions. And like Cruella, Bankhead was skin and bones and chain smoked. She was also known to have this very raspy voice, but the origin story for her raspy voice isn't what you would expect. Apparently, as a child, she got this horrible sickness that gave her whooping cough, and apparently she got the mumps, and this made her voice very hoarse. It says that she was also a very defiant child. She loved to bully her sister and her classmates, like she found it to be a fun thing to do. And just like Cruella De Vil in Dodie's book, Tallulah acted horrible in school, and she was actually sent to a bunch of convents and reform schools in the hopes to straighten her out and to stop her from acting like a rebel, but apparently she was expelled from two of those convents, so things weren't going very well for her. She just had so many similarities to Cruella that Disney really focused on her while they were making the movie. So yeah, this was the real life inspiration for the 101 Dalmatians Disney version. And yeah, I just found that to be really, really interesting because I didn't know any of this stuff. I didn't know there was a novel. I didn't know there was like a real life Cruella. So yeah, if you guys have any other interesting information to add, definitely comment it down below. And let me know if you've seen the newest movie. I have not yet, but I definitely will. But yeah, don't forget before I go, if you would like one of the new summer merch shirts, my wings are just hiding right now. I've linked it down below, but I hope you guys have an awesome rest of your day and I will see you in my next video. Bye!